everyone, this is Anubhuti from SinCity.com. Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to review and show you the swatches of Sugar's newly launched lipsticks, which is Blush Hour Matte Lipstick range. So Sugar Blush Hour Matte Lipsticks has been launched in six shades, and I have all of them, and I'm going to show you the review and swatches of all of them. So I'm going to do this video in two parts. First, I'll do a little bit short review about these lipsticks, and then I'll show you the swatches of all six shades. So without any further ado, let's get on with the video. So this is how the Sugar Blush Hour Matte lipsticks look like. These have this typical sugar packaging with blue and cyan shades, and it has the product name and the shade name is written here, and all the price related information, the product size, MFD by, it's written on the outer packaging. So when you open it, the inner bullet lip looks like this. It is square shaped. It is a little bit small looking packaging than Sugar's it's Rivet matte lipstick. So it's different than this. It looks smaller than this, but this is a full size lipsticks. It houses 3.9 grams of lipsticks. So this is how the lipstick looks like. This is a typical lipstick kind of packaging, which is not like Sugar's previous Vivid lipstick range, which has the round shape a lipstick bullet. So this is typical lipstick bullet, and this is the full size product. This is quite lightweight, and which is why I am liking these, because you can carry it anywhere, and this is smaller, so it can easily fit into your pocket. There's one drawback that you cannot identify the lipstick just by looking at it. So this is not color-coded packaging, and I would have appreciated if they would have made it color-coded, because there is so much going with the packaging. Like, there is one, this tab is here, then this tab is here or here. Anywhere they could have made it color-coded. So that's about it. Coming to the texture and feel of the lipstick, when I first applied it, I could not believe how smooth and how soft the lipstick felt on my lips. It literally feels like those mousse lipsticks, like NYX Soft Matte Lip Creme. So it feels like that. It is super soft, glides on super easily. So generally how I apply my lipstick, I apply my lipstick and then I blot it with the tissue paper, but with this lipstick I just swiped it across and I took my tissue paper, I blotted it, and there was nothing. Like, very minimal of the product was there on the tissue, and one swipe was enough to deposit the product on the lips. So it is pretty pigmented, the texture is mousse like it feels like liquid lipstick in a bullet form. Now coming to the staying power, these lipsticks go on for about good 5 to 6 hours with minimal fading if you're eating. And this one, I have applied it in the afternoon at around 1 o'clock, and then I have had my full fledged lunch, spoons with sabzi and everything, and still there is so much lipstick on my lips. I have not done any touch up or anything like that, so this is how it stays on the lips. It is pre-pigmented, it looks good, and it can go about like more 3-4 hours. So this is it. I'm pretty impressed with the quality, with the staying power, and it is not feeling as dry as the Vivid matte range. So I would not call it a creamy matte, this is like moussey matte. Feels ultra comfortable on the lips and stays for quite long, and it retails for $499, so yeah, under $500. So that's about the review. Now let's move on to the swatches, and after the swatches I will share my final verdict with all of you. The first shade is Cherry Jane. Second shade is Tinkerbell. third sheet is mini morph. The fourth shade is Powerpuff Girls. Fifth shade is Berry Boop. Last shade is Little Bo Peach. So those are all the swatches, and I've shown you both arm and lip swatches as well. My favorite shades will be Cherry Jane, Mini Mauve, and Little Bo Peach, Tinkerbell. Coming to the transfer proof, I just applied the lipstick and we'll do the transfer test. As you can see, there is nothing on my hand right now. I hope you can see there is very, very minimal transfer, and if I let it sit for like five minutes on my lips, the transfer will be negligible. Almost, I have sipped my juice and my tea and my coffee throughout the day, and it did not transfer on the cups. Though while having food, I could see a little bit transferring on my hand because the food was a little bit oily. Other than that, I could not see any much transfer on the cups and paper cups and glasses. So these lipsticks are 5 out of 5 from my side. Two shades which were a little hard to apply. One was Powerpuff Girls, and other one was Little Bo Peach. So these two took a little harder to apply. Otherwise, all the shades were like, whoa, so soft. So these are like super soft. Staying power is quite good. Like good price range, good comfortable wearing texture. So yeah. These lipsticks get a thumbs up from my side, and one thing which I really like, that all the shades are like different ones. These are not the shades which you get easily. So like first one, Cherry Jane, this looks quite similar to MAC All Fired Up, a little bit darker but quite close to All Fired Up. The Tinkerbell is very different kind of brown. I am literally afraid of browns, and this is a really comfortable shade of brown which I would go for. Then there is Mini Morph. So this is like a typical pink based nude for many skin tones. And then there comes Powerpuff Girl. So this is like a brown based, little bit of orange mix brown. So this is also a unique shade which you do not get in many lipstick ranges. This one is Berry Boop. This is quite dupable shade, and I would say close to many berry lipsticks available in the market. And the last shade, Powerpuff Girl, Little Bo Peach. This is quite unique. This is very different. This has a very good mix of peach color in that nude, pinky nude lipstick. This is more on the peachier side. So the shade range is good, price point is good, staying power is good, and the texture is quite comfortable. So these lipsticks get 5 out of 5 from my side, and totally recommend it. So that's all from my side. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon, which you get so that you get that notified whenever I upload a new video. And for product reviews and more, head on to my blog suncity.com. And yes, I will be doing a detailed review on my blog super soon with my lip swatch pictures. So stay tuned. Bye bye.